I'll start by creating a new project. So Spring Project 06. And here I'm gonna have an application event listener that I'm gonna put in this package. A driver class that I'm gonna call Spring App 06, and that is gonna have a main method, and I'm gonna call my Spring XML configuration file, Spring Beans.xml. From the downloaded Spring zip and Commons logging zip, I picked up these jars, and I'm gonna put them on the class path. So go to properties and Java build path, and I'm gonna add them to the class path. And now going back to the application event listener, it's gonna implement the application listener. And by implementing that interface, gonna add this on application event method that takes in an application event, and let me call it E. To trigger the application events, let me go back to the driver class, and I'm gonna start here by picking up a class path XML application context, passing in springbeans.xml. And actually, let me do one thing on the springbeans.xml. So I want to declare the application event listener as a bean, so I'm gonna put it inside the beans tag, so I'm gonna have this bean. So the ID is application event listener, and the class is com.ca.tutorial.spring.application event listener. And what this is gonna do, it's gonna bind this listener to the context. And that's all what I need to do on the XML side. So let me go to the driver class here. I'm gonna come, I'm coming back here. So I'm gonna use this context to do a start on it. And what this is gonna do, it is gonna trigger an application event that I'm listening to here, and specifically it's gonna trigger a context started event. So I'm checking if this application event is an instance of context started event, and I can do the handling here. But in this case, all what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna print out process context started event. And going back to the driver, I'm gonna do context dot stop, which is gonna trigger a context stopped event that I'm gonna be handling here. And for the purpose of this tutorial, all what I'm gonna do is print out a this process context stopped event. And now going back to Spring App 06, I'm gonna do context dot close, which is gonna trigger a context closed event, and that I'm gonna handle here just by doing this print line statement. And also when the context is refreshed or initialized, it's gonna trigger a context refreshed event. So I'm gonna handle that event here. So if e instance of context refreshed event, I'm gonna go ahead and also print the line process context refreshed event. So let me go ahead and try it out. So again, what I'm gonna be doing is trigger those events by calling start and stop and close on the context, and then I'm gonna see if this listener is gonna be able to pick up those events and print out each event that happens. So let's go ahead and run it. Save all, and here we go. So I have a context refreshed event initially, and this is triggered since the context was initialized here, and then I have a context started event because of the context.start. And then context stopped event because of context.stop, and for context.close I have a context closed event. And there is one more event that I didn't discuss here, and that is request the handled event, and that event is web specific, and it informs the receivers that a web request was received. But since here I don't have a web application, I'm not gonna show it.